Very good morning. Abita, we already started this revision of this chapter, A Truly Beautiful Mind, yesterday only. And we discussed this point, Einstein as a little boy, in detail. Fine, so we will be moving on to next point. So in this chapter, we are going to read about Einstein as a little boy, as a human being, and how he became successful later in life. So we are going to get glimpses of how a person becomes successful. It's not in one day, 2 days, or few days. It is a matter of continuous efforts. Fine. And nobody can judge a little boy that he will be or she will be genius when they grow up. Fine. His mother used to call him freak. What does it mean? That he is mad. He had a big head and he did not speak at the age of 2.5 even. And everybody thought that he is having some problem. But when later on stages, he started talking only. And he never loved, you know, playing with different toys. He loved mechanical toys only. And he used to play all alone with his mechanical toys. So that was different about Einstein as a little boy. Clear? So let's continue. Now, Einstein's desires. Fine, let me tell you about his desires. Einstein was very good at studies, you know, very good. But even then he left school because, why he left school? Because he was always with, he was always having clashes with his teachers. Fine, always used to have clashes. And the reason was he never believed in mugging up the information, cramming the facts. He never liked history. He was interested in knowing why people fight rather than when people fought. Fine. So his mind was very inquisitive, very intelligible. And he wished to continue his education in Switzerland. So that was his first desire. You can note down. Wished to study in Switzerland. Why he wanted to move to Switzerland? Because people were very liberal. They were not orthodox. They were not rigid in their thoughts. They were very liberal when it comes to their opinion. So he was highly gifted in which subject? Maths and physics. Fine. Favorite subjects, plus he was gifted in those subjects, maths and physics. His desire was to continue education in Switzerland. He was gifted in maths and physics. He decided to study at the University of Zurich after schooling. Fine, you should know which university? After schooling, he wished to study in University of Zurich. These are the desires also. So then he found his fellow student Mileva Marik, a clever creature. Another character. He found match for his life in Mileva Marik. M-I-L-E-V-A. So he found this girl to be intelligent enough who could match his IQ. Fine. And then after this, I'm going to tell you about his work and marriage. Next point you can write down. So when he meets Mileva Marik, we'll talk about work and marriage. What sort of works he did and about his married life. Clear? At the age of 21, Einstein worked as a technical assistant. So write down this point. At the age of 21, he worked as a technical assistant and also grabbed the job of technical expert. It's an achievement if a person is getting job even after 20s, fine, 20, 21, it's a very young age. So he got job at the age of 21 as technical assistant, technical expert. And in 1905, please do note, you should know, work ke andar hum kya kya likh rahe hain? His publications. In 1905, his paper was published, right? Einstein's Special Theory of Relativity. Manji? Technical expert. At the age of 21, right? And then in 1905, his paper on... When there is a paper publication, beta, there is always a name or to it. So his in 1905, his paper was published. What was the name of this paper? Einstein's Special Theory of Relativity, jahan se wo famous hua. What is theory of relativity? E is equal to mc square. So this theory was very important concept of Einstein's life. It changed his life actually. Clear? This is the time to join, please, students now. So he wanted to marry Mileva when he was doing his work in physics. He met Mileva already. And he wanted to marry her. Finally, they got married also. But they could not live together. And finally, they got divorced in 1919. He got divorced. Why? Because he was so busy in his life. Maybe he was busy in experimenting, in writing, in theories and all. That personal life was going up and down. He could not make up with his wife. So finally, with Mileva Marik, he got divorced in 1919. Then he got married with his cousin the same year. They have not mentioned the name of the cousin here in this book, but her name was Elsa. Fine. That we have one more chapter in class plus one also. Albert Einstein at school. Then what sort of student he was? Usko school se expel kar dete hain and all that. What happened? So detailed account about Elsa chapter. Fine. So there we got to know that Elsa was there with her throughout whenever he was in need. So he got married to his cousin the same year. Fine. The next important point: Nobel Prize for Physics. Very prestigious prize this is. So for the subject of physics, he was awarded with Nobel Prize. And beta, in 1905, he wrote this, not published. Right? So change it. His paper got published, or you can say General Theory of Relativity, in 1915, it got published. That was the scientific revolution, and he received a Nobel Prize for Physics in 1921. You should know the dates and data. In 1919 he got divorced, 1921 he got Nobel Prize, and 1915 his theory is of relativity got published. Jahan se wo famous word. Fine, so make correction in that. He started writing it earlier, but it was published in 1915. Next point is immigration to US. Immigration to US, United States.
It can be E wala integration or I wala, IMMI. Yeah. So Einstein immigrated to US in 1933. In which year? In 1933 he got immigration over there. So now we'll be in a new turn in his life. When in 1933 he moved to US, what happened at that time? Nazi invasion. Aapne social science mein padha hua Nazis ke bare mein. Nazism. You have read about it. What happened in that? Remember? So Nazis invaded. They came into power in Germany. Fine. At that time, 5 years later, the discovery of nuclear fission in Berlin had American physicists in an uproar. And this started, you know, at that era. When Germany was in power and the nuclear fission was in existence, and they were scared, American scientists were scared that that is very dangerous for the world itself, for all the countries. And many of them fled also, and as Einstein had, and they were afraid that Nazis could build and use an atomic bomb also. They were scared of Nazis, that they have invaded, they can use any kind of, you can say, bombing and all can be done by them. So Einstein, being very responsible human being and very responsible scientist as well, he wrote a letter to Franklin D. Roosevelt. Who was Franklin D. Roosevelt? Anybody? American president. So aapko kuch bhi aa sakta, you should know. Fine, write down. Einstein wrote letter to Franklin D. Roosevelt. Are you spelling it? Yes. So he wrote a letter to President of America, and he warned him that a single nuclear bomb would make a mass destruction, that these nuclear bombs are very dangerous, that masses of people will die, not thousands and hundreds, lakhs and people will be affected. So many of them, many scientists, they just fled with us, you can say, fear only. But Einstein wrote letter to Franklin D. Roosevelt. But American secretly developed an atomic bomb and dropped them on Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki in August 1945, underline. If you have book, write down. In 1945, Americans dropped bomb or nuclear fission on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, which is also not good. We still, I told you already when we were doing this chapter, that nuclear bomb is not that ki bomb blast hua hai. It is a kind of slow poison, you can say. It's in the air that people start inhaling, they start dying, suffocating, and even till date, the children who are born there, they are affected by various disabilities. Fine. So that is the impact of war. That is the impact of nuclear fission only. So Hiroshima and Nagasaki mein bahut zyada nuksan hua in 1945. Next point is Einstein's sorrow. Einstein's sorrow, dukh. He was very deeply shaken. He did not like this act of America also. He hated why people were killed. He was not bothering about Japan, America, Hiroshima. He was bothered that any people from any country should not be harmed. He was a very humanitarian, you can say. Fine, he proposed to the United Nations for forming a world government, but his letter made no impact. Over the next decade, he got involved in politics for an end to the arms buildup and campaigned for peace and democracy. Usne jo letter likhi thi, uska koi impact nahi hua. He wrote, do you know, now we have a team of all the presidents and prime ministers can meet. What does it call?
assembly is not that. Research on this. Fine. I'm saying that otherwise, when this thing was going on, there was no countries were coming together to talk about this issue of world peace, and some decisions must be taken by all the presidents and all the prime ministers and all the officials. Yes, fine. So he knows the answer. So United Nations organization is there where all the different nations, the presidents, they do meetings and all, they decide for global peace, what should be accepted, what should be rejected, all together. Fine. So here, Einstein was the first one to propose this. He said that there should be a platform where everybody can talk. Everyone or one ambassador for each and every nation. So uski letter ka koi asar nahi hua UNO pe. This United Nations. But then he joined politics also, so that not because he wanted to get money, he joined politics because after joining only you have the right to make changes. So he started campaigning for peace and democracy. Last point is Einstein's death. After that, I'll be asking you the MCQs based on this chapter. I'll be sharing the screen with the children at home and you can write all your notebooks. Einstein died in 1955 and world celebrated him as a visionary and world citizen. He was not citizen of one nation. He died in 1955. Everyone started considering him as a world citizen because wo sabke bare mein sochta tha, not a one person in one nation or his own nation. He was a visionary, fine. When he died, what was his age? 76. He died at the age of 76. Clear? You should know this. Clear, but any doubt to anyone? This chapter is based on facts mainly. Clear? So, bahut sari questions ban rahe hain. Objective, let me share the screen with you all. And beta, those who are sitting here, kindly, I cannot show you the screen, so you need to note down the question. Computer hangs in between, I guess. Now again, I'm going to share with her. Were you able to see the screen when I shared? Send me feedback. Abhi beta, aapko screen dikha tha? Nahi, fine, okay. So just bear for a minute. Sometimes I'm sharing a site with her, that's why it takes time. Yes. Now, are you able to see the screen? Okay. Whose genius still reigns after 50 years of his death? Or more years ho chuke to. Obviously, wahan pe name likhe hue hain. M.K. Gandhi, Nehru, Stephen, Einstein. And answer is Einstein. We know that. Fine. Who is known as the name, whose name has become synonym of genius? Again, Einstein. When was Einstein born? 14 March 1879, 10 March 1878, 14 March 1877, 14 March 1875. Abhi aapne pages. 14 March 1879. 1879. तो अब जो पेजेस में आप ढूंढ रहे हो आपने कल नहीं सुना ध्यान से ठीक है जब प्रैक्टिस हो रही होगी उसी टाइम पे आपको सुनना तो ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर वेयर वाज आइंस्टाइन बॉर्न लेट मी गिव द ऑप्शन बल्गारिया अल्म जॉर्जिया नन यूएलएम जर्न एंड अल्म इज इन Germany. Fine. So you should know this. What did Albert's mother think of him? That he was a born genius. He is intelligent. He was a freak. He will rule the world. He was a freak. Very good. What did Albert's classmates call him? कोई जवाब नहीं देगा अभी. Parmeet. Unmute yourself and tell me. Parmeet, beta. What did Albert's classmates call him? जो answer नहीं करेगा, it means that child is not listening to the teacher. I asked Parmeet to unmute. कोई रिस्पॉन्स नहीं. आशना
मैम, ब्रदर बोरिंग.
यस, वेरी गुड. सो ऑप्शंस वर जीनियस, डल, ब्रदर बोरिंग, स्टूपिड. हिज फ्रेंड्स और क्लासमेट्स वुड कॉल हिम ब्रदर बोरिंग. लेट मी आस्क द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नाउ. This question also goes to online students. By what age did Einstein not learn to speak? 3.5, 4.5, 5.5, 2.5. Yes, Jia.
Ma'am, 2.5.
Yes, 2.5 is the right answer. How many times did Einstein utter a word when he learned to speak? When he was learning to speak, he would utter a word again and again. How many times? Twice, thrice, once, four times. Twice. Fine, right answer, offline students. What did Einstein love to play with? Mechanical toys is the answer. But pehle aap options dekhoge, chahe aapko answer pata bhi ho. Don't be overconfident. What did school headmaster say about Einstein? He would be a genius, he is great. He cannot be success at anything. None of the above. He cannot be success at anything. When did Einstein begin to learn playing the violin? At the age of 7, 8, 9, 6. Fine. 6 is the answer. Where did Einstein score good marks in all these subjects? Switzerland, Italy, Munich. None of the above. Are you sure? कहाँ पे लिखे मगन? कहाँ पे लिखे? Find out. Are you sure? Answer दिए तो बताओ. Sure? Yes, he was in a school in Munich only. Fine. He was getting good marks. Fine. Why did Einstein leave the school? He left the school for his good. He had clashed with teachers. He did not like discipline and order. All of the above. All of the above. He left the school for his good. He had clashed with teachers and he did not like discipline as well as order in the school. When did Einstein's family move to Munich? Where he was 15-month-old, 12-month-old, 14-month-old, 16-month-old. Read karo book mein se batao. Online students, this is for you. When did Einstein's family move to Munich? When he was 15-month-old, 12-month-old, 14-month-old or 16-month-old? Yes, when he was 15-month-old. Where did Einstein wish to continue his study? German, Munich, Switzerland, none. Switzerland, right answer. Why did Einstein decide to continue his study in Switzerland? Nobody will speak. Now, online students, beta, raise your hand. Yes, Harmeet Kaur, answer this. Usse pucha jata hai, wo nahi answer karta. Yes, Arush, beta, you can speak.
Ma'am, all?
Yes.
Ma'am, all?
Ye Arush ki awaaz hai.
Is it so? What happened to you, Arush? Is it you, or you can switch on the video to show me if you are there? Yes, अभी आंसर उनको मिलेंगे. Okay, switch on the video then. Okay, fine. You were there, na? I thought somebody else is speaking. So you have sore throat. Fine. So the answer is Switzerland was more liberal than Munich. I already told you while teaching only. Fine. So that is the answer. In which subjects was Einstein gifted? English and history, maths and history, maths and biology, maths and physics. Where did Einstein go after school? University? In Zurich. Very good. University in Zurich, Munich, German, Switzerland are the options. So Zurich is the answer for this. What did Einstein call Mileva Merritt? Clever creature, silly, Dumbo, a good lady. Clever creature. Why did Mileva Merritt come to university at Zurich? It was near her city. She liked the place. It was a good university. It was a university which gave degrees to women. Yes, at that time, there were very few universities which never gave degrees to women. So that's why she came there. At that time, very less number of women were interested in this segment, right? With whom did Einstein fall in love? Mileva Merritt, a girl from Munich, a girl from Germany, none. Mileva Merritt. At what age Einstein do his graduation? 21, 22, 23, 24? 21. And at what age he got job also? As technical expert. When did Einstein secure a job? 1901, 2, 3, 4. 1900? कोई four कह रहा है, कोई five, five तो option में नहीं है. When did Einstein secure a job? 1901, 1902, 1903, 1904. Fine, so fine, we are done with this. Have a nice day, beta. And defaulters, please send your notebook, beta. नहीं तो zero लग जाएगा बाद में, नहीं कहना.